It's rare for me to read a story and feel that that it's fortified spiritually. And this presented itself to me like a parable. There was so much love and wisdom and hope, and I was really and it also came to me in a somewhat spiritually turbulent time in my life, where, without going into detail, my husband and I as well had just been presented a kind of a stick in our spokes in our family. And so it was a little death. This thing that happened in our life was just a little death, which in tandem with reading this script reminded me that life is a series of rebirths. And that profoundly touched me, and I found it to be so beautiful. And Elise resonated with me quite deeply. And then I met Maestro, and there is such a grace and a wisdom and a fun. He's so fun-loving, and he's such an elegant man. And really, I only want to, at this point in my career, I want to have fun. I want to be in a holy environment. I want to be surrounded by good people. And that, and to me, this was a clear yes. And so we met, shared our stories. Also, my family had experienced at this very time, I had a cousin who had experienced a stillbirth with his wife. And that trickled down through the entire family as well. And so that was a complex grief that firsthandedly had impacted my life at the time. Which just informed my response to the script. We had met, and then the call, I think a year and a half later, came, it's it. We found financing with you. So, yeah, it was a delicious opportunity for me.
I think that I did an audition tape, and then Jordan came over to Vancouver, my hometown, and we met at my agent's office. And we made ghosts together out of toilet paper. And we sort of had conversations, and I told him some of the lines. And he decided to pick me.
Chemistry for me is always just mostly part willingness. I mean, we have no choice but to connect. And this guy is, I mean, you see what you see is what you get. He's a very open little dude. He just wants to have a good time. He's mischievous. And so am I. And he was probably even better behaved on set than I was most times. And you know, it's just easy. It's easy. He's a very savvy young actor, very deep in touch with his emotions. He has a very unique relationship with his own mom, which I was able to witness on a daily basis and see how she is very much a part of his process. And I hung out with his mom a lot and have worked with his sister before, so there was already immediately there was a closeness.
We didn't have a lot of time, and we had a child, which meant we only had so many hours of the day. So there were, on a couple occasions, times when I needed to move things along, and I asked Jacob to sort of bring me something that he might not have actually, this is only a couple times, but I'm being honest, something that might not have been organically present, and to his unbelievable quality. I don't know that he willfully refused. I'm not even sure you totally understand what I'm talking about, but he's not capable. He was not capable of phoning in anything. And on those few occasions when I was running out of time and I needed him to do it, he wouldn't. And I just find that an extraordinary gift, and I hope that never changes. Because he really did me a favor by doing that. I'll probably get kicked out of the DGA for saying that.
We were filming in, like, the Rockies and, like, in open plains and like in giant cliffs and rivers, so it's kind of, I kind of wanted to stay there for a long time because then I had to go back to Calgary where my hotel is. But then whenever we go on set, I get to explore Alberta. It was so awesome because I got to learn how to ride a horse and I got to feed baby goats, but they're really cute. Goats are really cute, especially the baby ones. but they do smell a little bit. And I got to ride a horse with no arms while it's trotting. And I also had to learn how to ride a horse without a saddle. If you do that, it kind of hurts, if you know what I'm saying.
It didn't really matter to me the size of the role. I loved the role. I loved that she was a woman sort of trying to find a new life and a new side of herself that she had ignored. And of course, I was so excited to work with Vera. I just love her work. I'm a fan. And even if we had had just one scene, if we just had one scene by the fire, I would have done it just for that. And it was really an extraordinary experience because we were in Calgary, and you remember how amazing the storms were when they came through?
Yeah.
And you got to ride a horse.
Hailing everywhere.
Yeah, it was just so beautiful. And to watch him running around with goats and, you know, just this wonderful human having a great time being a kid. And it's not always like that for young people on movies. But Jordan and I think all of us, you know, embrace this environment. And he just got to be free.
I told this story because I absolutely had to tell it. Everybody that involved had to tell the story. We are in a time when human stories are few and far between. We're telling stories about machines, and we're telling stories about mechanized humanity. And what I love about this particular story, and there are films like this, is its willingness to explore full throttle humanity with all its ugliness. You know, to take a character like Elise, the mother in the film, who is unwilling to not do anything in her power to hold a family together that's falling apart. And yet to allow her to do that in a way that is both heroic, but unbelievably and constantly human, is imperative for me as a human being to watch. The reason I believe we started painting on caves and telling stories was to learn how to be human. And I think that that is just as essential. It is vastly more essential today because there are there's less structure teaching us how to be human. So the stories we tell are essential. How do we get it out there? I think you guys, we need help. You know, people need to acknowledge what we've done, and what we've done is rare because we're willing to completely invest ourselves in a human drama with vulnerability and honesty.
It was essential for me to, I can only come from myself, it was essential for me to receive this. And the way I was going to receive this story was to interpret it. And it's true. It really is, now it's word of mouth. And it's, you know, it's critical response. Because this is, look, I've done these stories enough to know what are the roles that people see. And in the roles that I wish people would see. And, you know, and now I suppose even the medium has changed. Television has given a larger platform for stories like this to be viewed immediately. A film like this deserves to be seen on a tremendous screen in its entirety and in its majesty.
I don't feel like a different person, but I'm really excited to do this and celebrate and do all this press for a new movie. And I'm excited to move on to this one because this was a really fun one that I did. So I don't think I really changed. I changed in age, but I think that I was just really excited to come back here again for like the second year in a row. Because I came here last year and for room. And now I get to be here again for this wonderful movie.